The Philippines allows interzonal travel for fully vaccinated individuals, including senior citizens, but they should be able to present a domestic vaccination card or a certificate of isolation issued by the Bureau of Quarantine. They will also undergo health and exposure screening upon arrival in the local government of their destination. If tagged as a close contact of a probable or confirmed COVID-19 case, a fully vaccinated person may undergo a 7-day facility-based quarantine, and an RT-PCR test may be conducted on the 5th day after the date of exposure. A person is considered fully vaccinated after at least 2 weeks since receiving the second shot of a 2-dose vaccine or the first of a single-dose brand. As of July 1st, only 2.7 million Filipinos have been fully vaccinated. The Philippines aims to inoculate at least 58 million people this year. The Philippines logged nearly 6,000 new COVID-19 cases Sunday, bringing the country's total to 1,436,000. Of that number, 52,708 are currently battling the disease. 86 more people died, while close to 7,000 recovered. Some experts now fear a possible rise in coronavirus cases in areas affected by the Taal volcano's eruption.
I'm not sure kung connected na yan sa Taal volcano ano yung nangyayari doon, but it's already increasing slightly.
We've seen this before with regards to also in Cagayan early on with regards to the typhoons. We were suggesting that Taal, the provinces around Taal be given some level of higher priority in vaccination, because it will complicate the way that we will respond to both crises.
Vice President Lenny Robredo urges the Duterte administration to be more competitive after the Philippines was identified as one of the least resilient economies in its COVID-19 response. The Philippines placed second to last among 53 countries in Bloomberg's COVID-19 resilience ranking.
Dapat pag nakakatanggap tayo ng mga studying ganito, mag-assess saan ba yung problema natin? Ano ba yung kulang natin? Sobrang satisfied tayo sa ginagawa natin. Kaya hindi tayo nag-exert ng effort na humusay. Wala kasi tayong goal. Pero kontento na tayo kung nasaan tayo ngayon. Kaya ang problema, sakit ito eh. Pag hindi natin hinusayan, ang daming mamamatay sa sakit. Ang nakakalungkot pa nito kung may mga mamatay sa gutom dahil hindi natin na-manage ng maayos.
Robredo also expressed frustration over the billions of unused funds under the Bayanihan 2. The measure expired last June 30th, with unused funds amounting to 6.49 billion pesos. She says her office could have spent that money to help more people affected by the pandemic.
Pag nakita mo yung ganito na ang laking pera, tapos parang hindi pinahalagahan, hindi nagastos, sayang. Kasi ang daming magbe-benefit na sana. Sinasabi ng Pangulo na wala tayong pera, pero nandyan yung pera eh.
Apo.
Nandyan yung pera, hindi nagastos.